And joining us in the studio this morning is Commission on Elections Chairman, former Comelec Chair Sixto Brillantes. Welcome to Hot Copy.
Yeah, good morning. Good morning, Karen.
Do I still call you chair or former chair? Private citizen.
Private citizen, okay. Retired chair.
All right. Retired Chair Sixto Brillantes. First, are you helping any candidate? Yun muna, let's come clean.
Yeah, I'm acting as a consultant for some candidates.
For some?
Some, yeah. Right now, consultant for Grace Poe.
Okay.
I'm also acting as consultant for Rudy Duterte.
Okay.
Because he was my student, so Grace Poe, very close coming.
Okay. So in other words, you do have candidates approaching you and really asking for advice.
That's correct.
What about Vice President Binay? I'm curious.
Yeah, Vice President Binay is also a client of mine before.
Before.
And I've always been very close to him. Kumpare kung buo yan. And we've been talking also.
Okay.
But I'm not opening up, not until February 2, when my one-year ban.
Okay. So, in other words, professionally speaking, you are not taking in any clients?
Not yet.
Okay.
Not yet.
Secretary Marrojas, is he asking advice from you?
No, he's the only one that I'm not giving any advice.
Why not?
Oh, he's the only one that I don't think should become president of this country.
Are you serious? Why would you say that, considering you do have Secretary Mar, who's had the most experience? Well, other than Binay, I mean, he was DTI secretary, I think, for, twice. And DOTC secretary, he was DILG secretary. You're talking about a number one senator.
Seriously, I think that a candidate who ran for a national office for a lower position,
okay,
when he last faced the people, and he was rejected by the people for a lower position, has no business running for a higher position.
But then
remember, Marrojas ran for last faced the people in 2010.
Yeah,
he ran for vice president, and he was rejected by the people.
Okay, so, but then, just following from this argument, I mean, you do have Abraham Lincoln, who I think, I mean, in history, I don't know if he ran more than 15 times before he actually won the presidency.
That's correct. That's in the United States. In the Philippines, I could not recall any candidate who lost for a lower position, ran for a higher position, and won.
Is that right?
I cannot recall of anything. As far as I can remember, 25 years in the practice, I cannot recall anybody running for a lower position, losing in that lower position, and then running for a higher position and winning.
But then it doesn't make Marrojas less qualified, or it doesn't even make it impossible for him to win. I mean, timing is also a factor.
Everything is possible. He can win. I'm not saying he will not win, but as far as I'm concerned, it will be very difficult for him to win after he has been rejected by the people when he last faced the people. It would have been better if he had run in 2013.
So you're telling me your dislike for Marrojas is just a matter because he lost in 2010. It has nothing to do with his competency, his capability, or his skill set, or leadership style.
There are other reasons, which means when he lost in 2010, I don't think he performed well as DOTC secretary and the energy secretary. I don't think he performed well. See, and then, of course, there's the other reason, like, I am worried if Corina becomes the first lady.
Oh my God, are you serious? This is what being retired is all about, huh? You just say things on TV. But why is that a factor? I mean,
it is,
Corina is not running for office. If he wins, she's first lady.
Yeah, we have to worry. Remember, Imelda was the first lady.
And
the track record of Imelda would show that a first lady is quite influential.
But what's, I mean, you can't make this an argument during elections, can you?
No, of course not. But these are personal things to me. You know, to me, as far as Corina is concerned, I remember when she was still connected with ABS-CBN, she would interview me and she is talking about the PICOS being manipulated. And I don't really know whether she still holds the same position or the same concept or the same feeling that the PICOS will be manipulated for the coming elections. See, there are so many things that she has said when she was a commentator of this network.
So, but does it make you bitter?
I mean, no, it does not. It only, I'm just worried that if she becomes first lady and she will be the closest to the president, and I guess something might go wrong, no? If she has her own concept of what is fair elections, Maroas losing in 2010, filing a protest, and then not pursuing the protest anyway. Up to now, the protest is still pending before the presidential.
But then you do have to remember, people are voting for Maroas. They're not voting for, in other words, his first lady or his first family. Or even his mother, you understand me?
That's correct.
You are voting for a specific person, running for a specific position.
No, let me make it very clear, Karen. The initial reaction to Maroas is not Corina. This is just an added factor. The initial reaction for me is that for Maroas to have lost the elections when he faced the people in 2010, and then now he said, ituloy natin, continue ang daang matuwid. When the people rejected him when he was running for vice president, if the people want him to continue the daang matuwid, then the people should have elected Pinoy and Mar. But they rejected Mar, which means they did not want Mar to be the successor of Pinoy. I think that was, there's some logic to this argument. But tapos talo ka na eh. And then you don't want to run and face the people again.
Okay. Wow. You surprised me this morning. I thought this was going to be a slow day for me, frankly speaking. I was thinking, okay, Sixto Brillantes is coming to the show. It's a typical day for me, which always happens on Head Start. And as usual, my interviewee surprised me. Next. Now, let's talk about Grace Poe. The possibility, frankly, at the Comelec, she survived the set. But the Comelec is hearing her residency issue. Am I correct on this?
That's correct, yes.
Okay. Now, the residency issue is crucial for Grace Poe of when do you start counting residency. I want to ask you, if you were there at the Comelec now, I'm sure you've studied the case. What are the chances of Grace Poe, frankly, being disqualified based on residency?
Well, let me clear it up first.
Yeah.
The jurisdiction of the Comelec, Comelec has no jurisdiction over the qualification of any candidate running for president. They cannot rule on the issue of citizenship, natural born or not. They cannot,
so Comelec cannot? Okay.
Cannot, no. The reason for this is the jurisdiction of Comelec is provided for under Section 78 of the Omnibus Election Code.
Okay.
In fact, these are the cases filed by the petitioners, like Itatad, Elamparo, Dean Valdez, no?
Yeah.
They're questioning, they're asking the Comelec to deny due course and cancel the certificate of candidacy of Grace Poe.
Okay.
Now, if you read Section 78, there's only one ground.
For canceling?
For canceling,
certificate.
Yes.
Okay.
What is this ground? The ground is a false material representation in the COC.
I see. So what you are saying is the Comelec has no power or jurisdiction to even out citizenship. Clearly, the first battle was at set. Then it's bound. I mean, I'm presuming the Supreme Court at some point will tackle this. But even the residency issues of Grace Poe cannot be tackled by Comelec.
Yeah, because the provision of the Constitution is that a president, the qualification of a president can be questioned only by one body. The sole judge in determining the qualification of a president would be the Presidential Electoral Tribunal. Nobody else, not even Comelec. The jurisdiction of Comelec now is Grace Poe is merely a candidate. And therefore, can the Comelec say that you are not natural born or you do not have the residence and question the qualification of Grace Poe? Of course not. The question that should be resolved by the Comelec is she making a false material representation in his certificate of candidacy?
That's all.
That's all.
That's all.
That's the only ground.
So all the arguments in the newspaper, I wanted to ask you of, can Comelec disqualify Grace Poe and then Susan Roses may substitute her? The premise of can Comelec disqualify her on any other ground is completely first, not possible.
Not possible. Because of the jurisdiction of Comelec.
Yes.
Masyado naman, the Comelec could be too powerful a body to be able to disqualify a president or a candidate for president.
Yeah.
There's only one ground now, as I've said. Well, actually two, no? One is Section 78 now, when there's a false material representation in the certificate of candidacy. Now, is there? Did Grace Poe make a false material misrepresentation in her certificate of candidacy? As far as I'm concerned, no. She believes that she is a natural born citizen. She believes that she has the residence. And therefore, she should be allowed to run. Mm-hmm. If she wins, and therefore her victory is questioned before the Presidential Electoral Tribunal, then.
Okay. So, okay, let's say, hypothetically, let's move it to another argument. If it's the Supreme Court who disqualifies her, what about this argument of Susan Roses substituting? I mean, where does this come from?
Yung substituting Susan Roses, that's out of the question. Yeah. Kasi si Grace Poe filed the certificate of candidacy as an independent.
Okay.
Now, the rules on the Omnibus Election Code is very clear. The only way that you can substitute is when you are an official candidate.
Okay.
Because the prerogative to substitute does not belong to the substitute or to the substituted. It belongs to the political party. Only the political party can substitute. Susan Roses cannot say, I will substitute Grace Poe. Grace Poe cannot say, Susan Roses will substitute me. Or even those who are filing cases against Grace Poe cannot say, eto dapat ang substitute. The only authorized body that can substitute would be the political party.
Oh, okay. Now, where is this coming from? I mean, it's all over the papers. I mean, I found the argument to be, actually, I questioned it. It was during the weekend. It hit the headlines.
Well,
you're telling me it's not even possible to begin with, why would it even be in the headlines?
No, only because you're talking to Susan Roses. Susan Roses naman does not have the legal intricacies. And she would not really know.
Uh-oh.
And she feels that kung i-disqualify niyo yung anak ko, papalit din ako.
Sinabi niya yun?
Parang ganun.
Uh-oh.
Pero
technically, sinasabi niyo, hindi
pwede. Technically and legally and constitutionally, she cannot do it. It is not possible. Comelec will not allow her to become a substitute. Uh-oh. For an independent candidate.
Yeah, yeah. So when you're an independent candidate, the most you can do is back out. You cannot benefit from the substitution law.
Yeah, you cannot be replaced anymore because you don't have a political party who will make the nomination as a substitute.
All right. Now, just to go back, just to challenge you a bit, because you did take a while to, hit on Mara and Karina. What makes you trust also, hypothetically, no, I mean, I know all the spouses, by the way. The spouse of Grace Poe, Neil Liamanzares, although, of course, many say he's a nice guy, but then isn't it also fair game to say, well, you can worry about the first gentleman or Duterte's wives, for example, wife. I mean, I know that, he must have another partner. I mean, isn't this
That's all correct. Valid to be worrying also?
I mean, you mention Corina alone when all of them have their own partners as well and spouses.
That's correct. That's why when you look at candidates for president especially, you look at them in a holistic manner. Everything that's connected with them should be looked at. Okay, Grace Poe, she has a problem also with the husband.
This
has to be considered. She has, because the husband is not a Filipino citizen. Then he will become the first gentleman.
Does that matter? I want to ask you.
It will not really matter, especially if the husband has already said that he can probably become a Filipino once Grace Poe wins.
Well, Senator Grace Poe in DZMM said the husband, Neil, will renounce his American citizenship.
That's correct. And therefore, he's really a Filipino, so he can always come back.
So that's his issue, you feel?
Oh, it's not really a big issue to me.
Why isn't it a big issue to you?
Oh, because I don't know how big an influence the husband over Grace Poe.
Unlike?
Like Corina over Mara.
But isn't that unfair? Or what about Duterte's wife or his partner now? I mean, I don't want to be the one to...
Duterte, I don't know if yes.
A wife? I'm
although
assuming.
Although she's saying that there are so many ladies around her.
Isn't that a bigger cause for worry?
But that was also the issue against Arab in 1998.
So is, wasn't
did
that...
Did not really matter to the people. Let me make it clear, Karina. As far as I am concerned, I think Corina matters not as the principal reason why I don't like Mar Rojas, but because I think that she has to be considered in relation to Mar Rojas. This is one factor, as I've said, not the major factor.
You're shocking, I have to say. But okay, next, Duterte. A disqualification case was raised, okay, at the Comelec because Martin Dino filled up that he was running for mayor and not president. Now, could Duterte, frankly, be disqualified based on that?
Yeah, the first thing I would like to know is what kind of petition was filed against Duterte. I've not seen the petition yet. I understand it has to be a petition to disallow Duterte from substituting. There's no such kind of a petition. It is either a petition to cancel his certificate of candidacy, which has already been filed, and therefore the ground should, as I've said in Section 78, would be false material misrepresentation.
Okay. Like that, it was admitted by PDP Laban that it was frankly a clerical error.
That's correct.
And then Martin Dino signed it and then he didn't read it.
That is my position.
But then he was asked to explain why he shouldn't be considered as a nuisance candidate, one, for the presidency, and two, when he withdrew, it was as president.
That's correct, because he is not a nuisance candidate as president.
For you?
He cannot be. As far as I can recall again in my practice, no official candidate of a major national political party has ever been declared a nuisance.
Really?
Yes.
But then he withdrew already and he wrote the Duterte's
name. And with more reason that he can be substituted, because there are only three grounds for substitution. One is in case of death of the official candidate, or if the official candidate is disqualified. And the third is when the official candidate withdraws. What happened to Dino? He withdrew already his certificate of candidacy. And therefore, he can now be substituted by the political party that nominated him. Mm-hmm. This is PDP Laban. This is a national political party headed by the Pimentels. It has been there for a long, long time. Mm-hmm. You cannot say that a candidate of PDP Laban is a nuisance candidate.
Okay. Now, since we're at this, I want to ask you, who would, for you, make the best president? Since apparently you came in this morning completely unfiltered, you might as well. I'm curious, who do you think will make the best president?
Right now, I feel that Grace Poe should be.
Why is that? I mean, if I challenge you, aren't you a biased source? I mean, considering you did help FPJ.
I was one of the principal legal counsel of FPJ, the father.
So wouldn't this make your opinion completely colored? I mean, even if you're not working yet for Grace?
Yeah, in a sense that it will be. It has to be colored because I'm biased in favor of the FPJ and Grace.
So why is it? Why do you think Grace would make the best president? I mean, it's rare a former Comelec chief would be this open. On TV, by the way. On TV, let me say.
No, I'm saying I think based on the candidates that we have right now, I think that I've said already Mar Rojas is not okay as far as I'm concerned.
What about Binay? What's your issue with him? Doesn't he have long years of administrative, executive experience?
No, before Grace Poe actually filed her certificate of candidacy, I was really for Binay.
You were? Okay, I didn't
Binay
know.
Binay has been long my client, long before, the entire family. In fact, most of them are my clients. So, talagang very close ako, he's my compare. I call him pare all the time. When I see him, I don't call him BP, I call him pare. And of course, I would like to, before Duterte came in, if Grace Poe were disqualified, I would have gone to Binay. Binay is a second choice right now.
For you?
For me, yes. Pero ngayon, nagbabago na rin. Because the second choice might be Duterte na.
Okay. How far will you go? Or let's say if you
I still have up to February to think.
Yeah, but what will you do? Will you campaign with them? I mean, I'm curious.
How, no.
If you don't mind, sir, I mean,
I
last interviewed you, which was actually historical, you were leaving the Comelec the next day. Do you remember that?
That's correct, yes.
I interviewed you a day before you retired on Head Start.
Oh.
Now I'm interviewing you again as...
But that was 10 months ago.
Yes.
About February, about yes. January.
Yeah, how old are you today, if you don't mind? Did you celebrate your birthday?
I did celebrate my birthday last August.
So how, if you don't mind, sir?
No, it's okay. Everybody knows I'm 76.
76. So will you be campaigning? Will you go on the road?
No. I will be giving advice and act as a consultant of the candidate that I will support.
Now, since we're at it, who is your vice presidential candidate? Are you Cheese, Bongbong, Lenny?
I'm not opening up
Ringo.
Yet. Vice President, I will not open up.
You won't?
I have told you privately, but I will not open it up in public. Mm-mm. Not yet.
Why is that?
Only because I'm so close to two candidates. Vice President. Mm-mm. And I will just have to open up much later.
Okay. All right.